think you all are enjoying your stay at home, and you must be worried about the situation of the COVID. My dear friends, in this pandemic situation, which is there in all over the globe, you all must have gone through one very important term in the scientific literature as well as in the general newspapers or in common discussions, that is the immunity. And in the current scenario, one more thing is coming into play in this treatment area, and that is the herbal treatment. More importantly, in the India, we have a very strong background of the Ayurveda. You have gone through almost three lectures earlier, and in all those three lectures, you all have come to know that Ayurveda have the ultimate treatments for all the diseases. Here today, I'd like to talk about immunity and the medicinal plants. My dear friends, this immunity, term immunity itself is the term wherein you will find that our body used to defend against all the pathogens. This pathogen means that pathogens are any kind of the molecule which can cause disease, which can cause inflammation, which can cause any problem to our body. So this is the picture which is depicting that now we are facing one very dangerous threat, and that is the viral threat. And that viral threat is creating havoc in the Indian scenario or in the global scenario. Today, we are fighting against the COVID-19. We are fighting against the coronavirus, and this coronavirus is taking a test of our body. And we are very sure that Indians are having this kind of the immunity wherein we are having the rate of almost 60% of recovery and very less death. So this is all because of the traditional systems we are following. Traditional system means we are following our diet systems. We are following our daily routines. We are following our knowledge base. So all the knowledge base, all the data which is advising us to follow the regular lifestyle, follow the ideal lifestyle, follow the regular diet lifestyle. So all those things which were discussed in the earlier lectures, here I'll take it to the next level. And here, this is the picture in which you will see that both the male and females are having the same kind of threat and having the different kind of mechanisms. But overall, we can say that both of them can defend to the disease on their own. There will be no supplementary things necessary. So this is the normal mechanism in which we used to defend, we used to react, we used to respond to the variety of the pathogens, variety of the infections. Here in this case, you will see that these are the four pictures in which sneezing, coughing, or rising the temperature of our body, or getting some sort of illnesses. These all are actually supposed to be the diseases. But I think that these are the immune responses of our body. Sneezing, when something is entering inside your nasal passage, your nasal passage is trying to reject it, will try to expel it from your body, and eventually you will result into the sneezing, through which you will blow out the air with the enormous speed, and accordingly you will throw out the pathogen which is trying to enter. In the whooping or coughing also, it is the same. When something is there in your throat that is not your own, it will thrown out. Or in case of the temperature rise in your body, some of the antigens which have crossed these barriers, physical barriers, and entered into the system and caused some inflammation, that will be projected by your body as the response in rising the temperature. This rise in temperature was to kill the microorganism, or to defend against the pathogens. So similarly, if all these things are persisting, then we definitely be sure that these all responses are giving us some sort of the defense mechanism. So overall, immunity is the balanced state of multicellular organism. This balanced state of multicellular organism means what? That every individual organism is having this kind of a particular setup of our body, that we can have the particular defense mechanism against any kind of the pathogen or any kind of the microorganism. Secondly, these are the biological defense systems wherein we used to defend with respect to all those kinds of symptoms which we have already seen, or that will result into formation of some diseases, and these diseases are because of the unwanted biological invasions. Invasions means what? These are the biological entities like this virus, coronavirus. This coronavirus is entering inside your body and you don't have that kind of immune mechanism, that kind of immune system which resists, which fights against this coronavirus, and that's why we are not immune to those. But this kind of threats we have already faced. So how to defend with that and how our body will be immune with that, that we will see in the later slides. But the thing is, this particular immunity will provide us the tolerance to avoid any kind of disease, to avoid any response in the form of the disease. Or this is also having one technical term, that is the autoimmune diseases, wherein our own immune system is working against our own body. This is very dangerous disease, which you need to understand. Those autoimmune diseases like psoriasis or apoptosis causing in the cellular level. So these are the autoimmune diseases wherein our own system will work against our own molecules or our own body. So this immune system is having the particular three line of actions or three level of actions. First level of action, it is the physical barrier of entry points. This means that we have the huge organ, that is our skin. Through this skin, we used to block all the pathogens from its entry inside the body. Secondly, if that barriers have crossed by some of the pathogens, because this will happen, if those barriers have been crossed by any microorganism or any pathogen, then our innate immune system will start, wherein our body or individual cells will synthesize some sort of a specific chemical molecules, and those chemical molecules will work against, will fight against those pathogens. This is called as the immune one. Because, means this is the power which already we have. In other case, in the third level of the immunity, we have adaptive immunity. Adaptive means this will be the immunity, this will be the defense mechanism which we develop only after an incidence, only after an exposure for the particular organism. So these are the three levels of the defense, three levels of the protections which we have in our body, which are actually the types of immunity we have. Here you will be able to see that types of immunities are of basically two types. First, it is the innate immunity, and second, it is the acquired immunity. In case of the innate immunity, this innate immunity is the immunity or immune power which we have due to whatever the profile of body, whatever is the genetic setup of our own, is blessed by the God, blessed by our parents. So that immunity will be the innate immunity. To this immunity, or this immunity is coming to you from your mother. So if this immunity is not enough, because this will never be enough, because we used to face every day, every instance with the new kind of the pathogen or new kind of the micromolecule or new kind of the microbe. So in those cases where we don't have that potential, in that cases we should go for the acquired immunity. So we need to acquire that immunity, and this acquired immunity is also divided into two types, that is the active immunity and the passive immunity. In case of active immunity, we are directly working against the disease. So this will be developing the response to the particular pathogen through our own body mechanism, and that will be depending on only infection, and after getting particular type of the immunization, we will be immunized. So this is the acquired immunity, wherein we can have the natural and the artificial. In case of the natural immunity, we used to develop the biomolecules, we used to develop the antibodies against the particular infection. Whereas in case of the artificial one, we will get the things from the external sources and get our immune system stronger. Similarly, in case of the passive immunity also, the same is the case, that we have the natural and the artificial one. In case of the passive immunity, we will not be directly developing the immune system. This will be going on simultaneously. After an exposure of the pathogen, we will develop this kind of the immunity, which is the passive immunity, which will develop after you receive the antibody from any source. So that will be also from the natural as well as from the artificial source. Nowadays, in case of this COVID-19, you all are aware that there is one theory or one practice in discussion, that is the plasma transfer. So this plasma transformation is the theory, or is the practice, is the treatment which will give you some sort of antibodies introduced into your body through the transfusion, and you will get immunized because someone has produced the antibody, and now you will get the ready-made antibodies. I think this all mechanism of the immunity will be explained very well through this video. This is the video produced by Science ABC on the topic, that is immune system, innate and the adaptive. Here it is the link for that video. We will go through that video. You will be very good to see that and try to get to know about the complete immune system through the video.
Our body has a powerful army that protects it from various types of threats. These threats can come in the form of mechanical injuries, the entry of germs, or the entry of other foreign particles like dust. This personal army is called the immune system. Every day, we encounter a huge number of bacteria, viruses, and other disease-causing organisms. However, we don't fall ill every other day, which is due to our immune system, an army of cells that is always roaming our body, ready to ward off any attack. The immune system can be broadly divided into two parts, innate and adaptive immunity. Innate immunity, or non-specific immunity, is the body's first natural defense to any intruder. This system doesn't care what it's killing. Its primary goal is to prevent any intruder from entering the body, and if it does enter, then the immune system neutralizes this intruder. It doesn't differentiate between one pathogen and another. The first component of this defensive system is our skin. Any organism trying to get into the body is stopped by the skin, our largest organ, which covers us. Secondly, there is the mucus lining of all our organs. The sticky, viscous fluid traps any pathogens trying to get past it. These are the two physical barriers. However, we also have chemical barriers, such as the lysozyme in the eyes or the acid in the stomach, which can kill pathogens trying to gain entry. The genitourinary tract and other places have their own normal flora or microbial community. These compete with pathogens for space and food, and therefore also act as a barrier. The next line of defense is inflammation, which is done by mast cells. These cells are constantly searching for suspicious objects in the body. When they find something, they release a signal in the form of histamine molecules. These alert the body, and blood is rushed to the problem area. This causes inflammation and also brings leukocytes, or white blood cells, which are soldiers in our body's cellular army. Once they come, all hell breaks loose. Sometimes, however, the intruder may not be a germ, but rather a harmless thing like a dust particle. The body still causes a full immune reaction to this intruder, which is how allergic reactions occur. In the fortress of our body, the leukocytes are VIPs. They have an all-access pass to the body, except, of course, to the brain and spinal cord. Our leukocytes come in many types. Those that belong to the innate system are the phagocytes. These cells can either patrol your body, like the neutrophils, or they can stay in certain places and wait for their cue. Neutrophils are the most abundant cells. They patrol the body and can therefore get to a breach site very quickly. These cellular soldiers kill the infectious cell and then die, which leads to the formation of pus. There are also the big bad wolves, or the macrophages. These cells are like hungry, ravenous monsters who simply engulf unwanted pathogens. Instead of roaming freely in our blood, they are collected in certain places. These cells can consume about 100 pathogens before they die, but they can also detect our own cells that have gone rogue, such as cancer cells, and kill them too. Beyond that, we also have the natural killer cells. These cells can efficiently detect when our own cells have gone rogue, or are infected with, say, a virus. NKCs detect a protein produced by normal cells called the major histocompatibility complex, or MHC. Basically, whenever a cell isn't normal, it stops producing this protein. The NKCs move around constantly, checking our cells for this type of deficiency. And when they find an abnormal cell, they simply bind to it, release chemicals, and destroy it. The last cells of our innate immune system are the dendritic cells. These are found in places that come in contact with the outside environment, such as the nose and lungs. They are the link between our innate and adaptive immune systems. They eat a pathogen and then carry information about it to our adaptive immune system cells. This information is produced and shared in the form of antigens. Antigens are the traces that pathogens leave behind. They are molecules found on the surface of pathogens that can be detected by our adaptive immune system for recognition. The dendritic cells pass on this information to our T cells. However, macrophages can also perform this function. Now, there is also the adaptive or acquired immune system. This system is more efficient as it can differentiate between different types of pathogens. It has two main components, T lymphocytes and B lymphocytes. T cells come into play when an infection has already occurred, thus bringing about the cell-mediated immune response. B cells join the fight when the pathogens have entered but haven't yet caused any disease. This is called the humoral immune response. Some T cells take signals from the dendritic cells or macrophages and are thus called helper T cells. They perform two key tasks, forming effector T cells, which are basically cells that cycle through the body and call in the cavalry, namely other white blood cells. Helper T cells also form memory T cells, which keep a record of this antigen for future reference. Sometimes, some cells of our body know that they have lost the battle. They have become heavily infected with pathogens, so there is no hope left for them. At this point, the immune system brings out the cytotoxic T cells. These cells rush over and perform a mercy killing for the infected and dying cell. Furthermore, we have the B cells. They produce chemicals called antibodies, which fit on the antigens of pathogens, much like how a lock and key fit together. These antibodies crowd around a pathogen and act like tags. They signal the macrophages to come and kill the marked pathogen. B cells also produce memory B cells when they encounter an antigen. The B and T memory cells jointly maintain a record of all encountered infections and thus strengthen and solidify the body's immune response to these infections in the future. Our innate response is quicker, though nonspecific. It gets into action within hours and is pretty strong. However, when things get out of hand, the innate system calls for help from the acquired immune system. This system can take days to mount a response, but the next time we encounter that pathogen, it won't make us get sick. In short, every day that we spend being healthy is all thanks to our immune system, so it definitely deserves our respect.
So, dear friends, have you seen the video? I think this video made it very clear that what exactly is the innate immunity and what exactly is the acquired immunity. So in the case of COVID-19, we are completely depending upon the acquired immunity. And for that purpose, we need to have some specific kind of vaccine which will provide us the immune system or which will provide us the immune power. So my dear friends, this immunity is acquired through first and foremost, that is the vaccination for which we are waiting. Second, it will be called as the contracting the disease. Contracting the disease means what? This will be the artificial infection of the pathogen, which will be just like the natural one, but it is not the natural. So you will be developed with the disease. That will not be the actual disease. This will be the mimic disease. So you will be contracted with the disease, and once you contract with the disease, contract means what? Contract means this will be a dual agreement. This will be two-way agreement in which you will be agreed to have the disease, and disease will agree that I will not cause any threat to you. But the thing is, your immune system will work against that. It will get the time to develop the antibodies, and accordingly you will develop the antibodies. And once you develop the antibodies, then after exact entry of the natural pathogen, natural microbial organism, you will be able to fight it, because you have already developed your own immune system against the disease. Third one, that those persons who have already developed the antibodies, from those persons you will get the antibodies in the form of a plasma, get it introduced, injected into your body, and that antibodies will multiply in your body against the specific pathogen, they will work. Moreover, those antibodies will start to synthesize in your own body also, because that will be the population of microbial viruses in your body, and at the same time your body will have the one immune memory with it, and it will amplify it with the help of your own system. So once you get the antibodies from anybody, then your own body will also start to synthesize that antibodies in your own one. So this immunity is now in discussion, that is the herd immunity. This herd immunity is the immunity of the masses, is the immunity of the nations, is the immunity of the states, is the immunity of the societies, wherein immunization will be one of the way in which the entire disease can be fought. In case of the earlier stories, we have gone through this kind of a treatment. We have gone through a mass immunization. You are aware of the stories of smallpox, polio. We are doing the same, that we have the national mission to fight against the polio. Teen boon zindagi ke, do boon zindagi ke. Amitabh Bachchan is advertising the vaccination program. So through this vaccination program, now we are on the verge of the complete eradication of the polio from the nation. So similar kind of programs we have gone through regarding the variety of the diseases, and in the same way, we are very sure that we will be definitely tackle this COVID-19 situation with the mass immunization program that will be called as the herd immunity. Once we develop the herd immunity in our society, then definitely the threat of coronavirus will be eradicated. So here, this is all about the success stories in the entire world, wherein these are the strong diseases which have caused the huge threats to the human population. But because of the immunization program, these diseases are completely eradicated. Now we will eradicate COVID-19 too, we are very sure. But the thing is, my dear friends, here this is the very indicative picture, wherein you will be able to see that the smaller kids will have the greater immune system, immune boosters, immune power. But as we grow older, our immune system will be weakened. So what may be the reason for this weakening of our immune system? Because actually it should happen like a reverse way, because at the older age we will be more prone to the diseases, and for those diseases we need the stronger immune system. But unfortunately, this is the natural way in which the older peoples will lose their immune power. So to develop the immune power, to maintain the immune power in all the ages, there should be some sort of the specific efforts we need to carry out. So what exactly will be the way in which we can build our immunity? That is the question. So for this purpose, there is the specific way in which you can introduce, or which in which you can go for some sort of the biomolecular interventions in your body through a specific intake of the natural products, and that natural products will give you the specific chemical compounds which leads to strengthen your immune system, strengthen your protective power. So this is one of the paper in which you will find that this is the directing the immune system with the chemical compounds. And from where these chemical compounds will come? These chemical compounds will come from the natural sources. So these are the chemical compounds which we want to have in the form of whatever we used to consume. That will be in the form of a nucleic acid, that will be in the form of lipids, that will be in the form of sugars, peptides, or multiple small biomolecules that are the vitamins, nutrients, macronutrients, micronutrients, or all the kinds of biomolecules which we will be able to consume from the natural resources that are our own plants. Those biomolecules will be definitely give our immune system a booster dose, so as our immune system will be stronger and we will be developing the adaptive immune response. So my dear friends, from where we will get this, that is the main question, and it is the paper wherein this paper entitles Nutritional Modulation of Immune Function Analysis, Evidences, Mechanism and Clinical Relevance. Friends, in this paper it was clearly mentioned that whatever are the biomolecules available in the plants, that biomolecules are having the enough potential or maximum potential to develop or to modulate. Modulate means what? At a specific time it will increase, at the specific time it will decrease. So this will modulate our immune function, and accordingly we will get the specific kind of the immunity. So friends, this is the way in which we will get the particular nutrients, and those nutrients, because of deficiency of those nutrients, we were having the impairments in the immune system. Now we will be supplementing it from the medicinal plants for developing our immunity. So this will increase our immune power, and finally this kind of the biomolecules, these biomolecules are having the strong potential to develop our immune system, to strengthen our immune system. So these are the things which we expect to consume from the medicinal plants. So medicinal plants are the very good source of such kind of the biomolecules which will improve our immune system, and these immune system improving molecules will be molecules which will cause these all properties. These are the first, these will be inhibiting the inflammatory mediators, or these will be blocking the inflammatory compounds, and this will be giving you the anti-inflammatory functions. Secondly, this will be giving you the cell mediated immunity. It means that the specific population of the cells will be increased in your body. This will be alteration of the antigen presenting cell functions. This means that how the antigen will be identified by the antibodies or our immune system, that mechanism will be strengthened with the help of such kind of the biomolecules. This will be simply making it very easy to go for acquired immunity from our innate immunity. So overall, these all are the plants which are giving you the good quality of the biomolecules which offers the specific kind of the immune power to you. This is the cranberries, apan marathi jala karvanda manto, your mustard seeds or nuts or the mushrooms, chili, artichokes, that are the jala apan marathi madhe alucha vada manto, yogurts, pomegranate, garlic, oysters. These all are the immune boosters. These immune boosters will be helping you for developing your immune power. So this is the Super 16 food court, where all the food materials, all the plant materials are giving you the enough immunity. Let me see one by one. These are the leafy vegetables. These leafy vegetables, you will be able to see that all the spectrum of leafy vegetables we have. And in this case, these are the international kind of the vegetables. Let me come to the Indian one. So simply cabbage, fenugreek, coriander, pudina, all those green leafy vegetables, mind well, leafy vegetables are the source of good molecules which will be loaded into your body with the nutrients and the micronutrients. This will be also provide variety of the vitamins along with the calcium, iron, magnesium, potassium, etc. And very importantly, these vegetables, leafy vegetables, will be very rich in the antioxidants. These antioxidants are giving you a very significant effect of the anti-aging. So along with the anti-aging, that are giving you the immune potential. So these leafy vegetables are the good source of the biomolecules which will supplement your immune system. Similarly, this is the root vegetables. These root vegetables are the immune strengthening because they have stored great amount of nutrients in them. And very good to see that these are the root vegetables which gives the protection to your respiratory system. Right now we are facing the same problem. Respiratory system is in the greater threat because of the coronavirus. So this will be helping you. These root vegetables are rich in the soluble and insoluble fibers. These will help you to build the gut health, respiratory tract and the gut health. You can imagine how important and how easily this can tackle with the coronavirus. It is dealing with the respiratory system, it is dealing with the gut flora. Both of them are the entry point for the viruses, coronavirus. Now, this will be the garlic, onion, ginger, the three components which are very common in our kitchen. So these are also giving you the very rich amount of the sulfurous compounds, and that sulfurous components will be preventing from the cancer, or these are giving you the flavonoids which are the immune boosters. Similarly, many of the specific components, specific biomolecules are there in the garlic, onions and the gingers. They are giving you a specific powers which will be helpful in the daily life. Similarly, this is the peppers, chili. So this chili is also giving you the specific kind of the capsaicin, and that capsaicin is the source of vitamin C, which will be again important for the immune system and specifically fighting in the colds and flu. So this is the way in which chili is helping you. Here are the squash or the pumpkins, the variety or the spectrum of the pumpkins we have in India. So all those pumpkins are, see here, they are rich in antioxidants. They are rich in vitamin A, vitamin C, manganese, magnesium, folate. All of them are giving you the stronger immune system. So you can imagine how important these are. So these pumpkins are giving you the powers. Similarly, apricots, citrate fruits, berries, pulses. I'm not going in a detail. You can go through the PowerPoint and read the specific properties or specific biochemical components from these kind of the plant materials. So green peas, sprouts, these are giving you a specific powers. That power boosters are the power boosters in the form of the biomolecules which these divine plants are giving to us. So my dear friends, we should be very careful in our diet. Here you can see that nuts and the seeds, curd, yogurt, these are giving you the very good powers. Here in this case, the curd, it is giving you the probiotics. Probiotic means these are the biological entities which are entering inside your body. And as you have seen in the video, these are the microbial populations there in your body which are the helping microbes. They are the good bacteria. Those bacteria are coming from the yogurt or the curd that will be giving you immune power. Turmeric, honey, natural products. These are the natural products which are giving you the benefits. This is the health mix. Now, this is quite the important, very important way in which we will be preparing our own health mix. As far as the situations are prevailing, you can prepare your health mix, and that health mix will be including the all 16 power booster plants and in a specific quantity. That health mixes are giving you different kind of the molecules for the specific purpose. Say for example, if you would like to have the development of the particular hemoglobin in your blood, then what sort of health mix you should prefer, that will be a specific one. So accordingly, you will decide what should be the health mixes, and that health mixes will be helping you. These are the trees. Now, whatever the plants which we have seen up till now, those were the herbs or those were the vegetables. Now we are coming to the immune booster trees. These are the all trees. Almost we can say that almost all the trees are having the power to help your immune system. So only the thing is, some of them are having the roots with the potential, some of them are having the rhizomes with the specific potential, some of them with the flowers, some of them with the seeds, some of them with the flower particular nectars. So all the parts of the plant will be having the specific impact. Say for example, in case of the turmeric, you will be able to see that turmeric is having different chemical population in the rhizome than the leaves, than the flowers. All of them are having the very specific combination of the molecules which are helping you in the different aspects. So all the body parts of the plants are having the different properties, so we should take care of the every part while using it. Here you can be saying that almost 47% of the leaves or whatever are the plant population working for a specific disease and a specific organ is in use. Here in this case you will be able to see that almost 47% of the body parts, that is the leaf. Leaves are comprising 47% of the entire body parts. This it means that every plant, almost every plant's leaf will give you some sort of the benefit. So this is the good one to go with. Just chewing the leaves will give you relief from variety of the disorders. Along with this, some of the plant products are there. Those plant products are like churna, it is the ras, it is the arka, it is the kadha, or it is the bhasma. All these are the plant products specifically made through a designed process which will give you a kind of a specialized benefit. So these all are giving you the benefits in your immune system. Nowadays this immune system is studied under the independent branch called as the immunology, and right now it is the synthetic immunology, because here in this case we have inclusion of almost all the branches. Even we have the engineered microorganisms to supplement with our immune system. We have some sort of knowledge from the chemistry. Biology is of course there, clinical sciences, fundamental advances, new therapeutics, all the sciences are coming together. All the classical theories are coming together for only one and only thing, that is the immunology. These all branches, these all sciences, these all theories, these all practices are only dedicated practices to develop our immune system, because immune system is the only way in which you will be able to develop or sustain your body profile in the situations like this situation of the corona pandemics. So I think that this all is about the applications of the medicinal plants in the development of our immune system. I think these entire plants which were in discussion are not the only plants. You can go for any plant, you will definitely find some sort of the biomolecule which will be helping you in your immune development. So dear friends, here it is the quotation that the cell in your body reacts to everything that your mind says. This was not there in the lecture, but this is very important. Every cell of your body is the particular responsible cell for your thoughts in mind. And eventually, I suggest that negativity brings down your immune system, whatever you are consuming. But if you think negatively in your mind, ultimately the power of those immune boosters will be going down and your immune system will be weaker. So be positive, think positive, and definitely we will be fighting with every disease, with every virus, with every pathogen, and we will survive because we are the human beings. So try to avoid the anger because it weakens your immune system. Try to keep your mind full of positivity, full of energy. That will be helping you to bring good things to you, to good health to you, and this will be giving benefit to the society also. Thank you. Thank you very much.